Hello, it's me again. I just thought I'd come on quick and show you guys. I haven't varnished yet, so it's kind of shiny. But I'm done with this baby's hair. I still don't know. To me, it looks like a boy, but it could be a girl. Could put a little headband on and, see? I like it, and I don't like it. I'm getting better. I like it. It's much better than any of the other hair that I've done. I like the light hairs in the front and dark on the top. But I don't like that the edges are so dark, but it's okay. It'll look better when it's varnished. So, for right now, I am going to eat this pastry. And then I'm going to finish varnishing little Mr. Gown Chin, and I'll show him to you. He needs some brown eyes. I ordered some brown eyes, so I'll be back. I'm back. It's the next day, actually. I'll show you guys the progress I've made on Miss Zoe here. I want to hurry up and get done with them so I can get the Mealy and Reuben done, because I really need to get moving on these Christmas babies. So this is Miss Zoe, and she's had we did the teal layer. And I did a, I did a flesh coat on her. My flesh coat is just, it's buff, golden titan buff, and a very, very tiny, tiny amount of pyrrole red. I like put a toothpick in the top and just swirl it around in the paint, and it's kind of pink. Makes kind of a pinky. I don't know where I put it. If I even have any left. Here's some. Okay, so. Nope, that's yellow. I thought I had it. Nope. Anyway, it's a good thing I got this out, because this is the color. I'm going to put a violet wash on her next. But I did, I did the flesh wash, and I did a Alizarin Crimson Hue. Light sponging, so let me see. Maybe it's kind of dark in here right now. Let me see if I move this over here. I don't know if you guys can see the really light mottling on her. Probably not, because it's hard to see on camera. But all right, it's morning. It's gonna be nice though. I think I get some pictures of Ashia today. Finally. My husband's like, you didn't take pictures? I thought you listed her already. Nope, sorry. I don't know. Anyway, I did some powders on her too. And also, I did a yellow ochre layer. So, that's all I've done so far. And I'm going to do it's not going to take a lot to finish her, because with toddlers, you don't put a ton of paint on them. So, this is... This is Gown Chin. I don't know if you guys can see or not. I don't know what's the deal with the lighting today. It's because it's early, I guess. But, oh. Here he is. He's kind of got like a Hispanic skin tone. So I put a couple washes of burnt umber on him. With brown eyes, he'll look good. Oh, you guys can see him better. In this. There you go. Maybe. Can you see better? Let me see. Oh, yeah. That's better. Okay. So, here he is. You can see his skin tone is kind of a reddish brown. So, he's going to get... I ordered him some brown eyes, because I also ordered blue eyes, but I think he'll look better with the brown eyes. So, he looks like he's like... Arr. Got one eye, one his eyebrows down, one eyebrows up. I can get him a pacifier, like a probably a preemie pacifier might work better, or I'll have to cut the end off of a pacifier to fit in his mouth. But yeah, He looks cute. Hoping to be finished with Sebby and Madeline this weekend. I can put them together. I really need to work. It's a crunch time. And I'm going to varnish a little, this little baby's hair. It's Renee. I need to give her some eyelashes, or him, her. I'm going to dress as a boy. It's still shiny, so it's hard for you guys to see the hair. But after I varnish it, I'll show you. So let's do a lavender wash on Miss Zoe here, because she still has sort of a bluish green hue to her. So need to, and yellow. She's got yellow now too. So we need to try to bring all that together. Okay, so we need brushes. Brushy brushes. I need water. Everybody, well, we've had a vacation. In October we had vacation. So Christoph was off for a week, so he went back to work this morning. It's Monday. And Maddie went back. She has a school that she goes to like once a week on Mondays. And then she has therapy and stuff during the week. So she went to her little school today. It's for people with disabilities. Okay. Okay, so we're just going to throw some paint on here like I usually do. Because she's a toddler. I'm not going to put a ton of, I do sponging layers on some toddlers, but she looks good with the washes, I think. She doesn't look as good with the sponging layers. But I wanted to get that one, to give her some depth to her skin. I wanted to get that one on there. I'm gonna just kind of rub this around so I can make sure we get it everywhere. I'm hoping this, I don't want to make her too dark. I'm worried about, that's why I'm being careful with the colors I use, because she's already got really dark vinyl, so I don't want to make her that dark. I also kind of emphasized her lips a little bit with some color, some paint. See, I can see better where her lips are because they're so, the color of her vinyl, it's hard to see where her lips are. So I just kind of accentuated them so they're better to see, because it's easier for me to see how her skin tone is moving along when I can see her features, if that makes sense. Okay, to get all these little, here, I'm going to put some more in this ear, because I can get much in this ear. And this here ear. Get over here. I just want to mop up the puddles of paint. So just the tint is kind of left behind. I didn't say that again. If that makes sense. Oh, my arm. I am really ready for my new wheelchair. This wheelchair, my seat is not as comfortable as it used to be. I don't know if the gel is not working as well as it used to, because it hurts if I sit in this chair too long. Hurts my tailbone. Okay, oh, my arm. What is wrong with my arm? Not working very well today. So I need to try to sit up straight. I keep leaning over because I don't want to hit the camera. Okay, so. Crunch. Okay, so we'll see how she looks when she dries. See where we go next. I'm gonna do her limbs and I'll be right back. Okay, so this is how she looks. She's like a... I usually hold my hand up to her and you can see she needs more yellow in her skin. She still looks kind of pale. And her face looks pale, but if you look at her limbs are darker. But that's pretty normal because, like I said, the face for some reason doesn't take paint as well. I did put an extra layer of the purple, of the violet, on her face. You can see the arm is darker red. So she definitely needs some yellow. I don't know why I was trying to put that on there. So I got out, I'm going to do a layer of, which is usually my last layer, the raw sienna. So we'll see how that looks. But I want to do some powders on her first. So I'm going to do that and get a little bit of blushing and stuff. And then, because I haven't done a lot on her face, just mainly on her, like, her feet. Oops, her leg's still wet. You can see on her hands, she's got some more powders there, some blushing and stuff. So I'm going to do that, and then we'll do this. And then I'm going to varnish. I'm going to show you guys how to varnish a baby that has hair, because I'm all done with Mr. Benjamin. Benjamin! Yeah, and then we'll do the varnish on the painted hair. I know I've shown you how to do that before, but... we'll do it again. Okay, so I'll be back. I just thought I'd let you guys see really quick what Gown Chin looks like with eyes. There's in a different light. Let me see. I can see what you guys are seeing. There we go. Sorry, loud noise. So, I might do blue eyes. I don't know. What do you guys think? I really need to clean up my desk. There you can see he's much darker than I am. My husband's like, he's red. I'm like, he's supposed to be, but he's a baby. Babies are red. He's used to me doing toddlers and are really, really light-skinned babies. Anyway, I think he looks cute. Okay, what do you guys think? Do you guys like the blue eyes? I'll show you the brown eyes when they come. I got a box. I'm not very happy because this is supposed to be curly hair, so I'm going to have to complain to them because I bought it under the curly wavy hair because they weren't carrying it before, but they are now. I got the stuff about the German doll show, so they have one this winter and then they'll have another one in May. Of 2023. I need to go to a doll show. I have never been to a doll show. These are my little glass teeth. I got some more glass teeth. So, boop. And I got four of the little ones. So I'm going to put those over there. And I also got the eyes that I ordered for Gown Chin. After I just showed you guys with the other eyes, but these may be around kind of the same color. They should be darker, but we'll see. There we go. Yeah, these would be better. They're a little bit darker, I think. Let me see. Because I think these, maybe not. Maybe they're not darker. Let me see. Nope, I think they're the same, actually. Actually, these are a little bit darker, so I'll use these ones on my little, my friend's baby over here. But I did some, you can see I had some blushing on her. Let's see. can, you'll see. It's so dark in here. I don't know. There you go. You see the blushing on her. And I did her ears. So, I don't know. I think I don't want to make her too dark. And I think I like... She still needs to be a little lighter. Maybe I can bring that yellow up out of her skin if I did a flesh tone. Let's... Well, you guys can't even see anything. Over here. I was just saying, like, you see how... I don't know. Yeah, I think I better do another yellow. But I think maybe I'll do another yellow ochre because I'm afraid to do... This is so dark. Maybe if I... I need to mix it up. Maybe if I... I'll see if I can put any more water in it, if I can thin it out a little bit more. Because I usually do, the last wash, I usually do the raw sienna. This is the raw sienna. I think I'm just going to dump this and mix up some more because I know that I messed up and mixed in yellow ochre, but I'm going to make a fresh one of that. I got a box. I'm not very happy because this is supposed to be curly hair, so I'm going to have to complain to them because I bought it under the curly wavy hair. Because they weren't carrying it before, but they are now. I got the stuff about the German doll show. So they have one this winter, and then they'll have another one in May of 2023. I need to go to a doll show. I have never been to a doll show. These are my little glass teeth. I got some more glass teeth. And I got four of the little ones. So I'm going to put those over there. And I also got the eyes that I ordered for Gown Chin, after I just showed you guys with the other eyes, but these may be around kind of the same color. They should be darker, but we'll see. Here we go. Yeah, these would be better. They're a little bit darker, I think. Let me see. Because I think these, maybe not. Maybe they're not darker. Let me see. Nope, I think they're the same, actually. Actually, these are a little bit darker, so I'll use these ones on my little, my friend's baby over here. I don't like this. I'm gonna save this, but I don't like this kind of polyfill. It's like, feels all scratchy. I don't like it. The polyfill that I get from Pup and Tremolon. It's really soft and really dense. I'll have to show you guys the polyfill I use sometime. I think I've showed you before in like my videos, you know, where we build the baby, you can see. I save these little bags because you can use them for like sending things home. Like sending things home in your box openings and stuff. So they're good to hold on to, recycle them since they're not that great for the environment. So I just recycle them. Okay, so I'll see what the brown eyes look like on Gown Chin when I get them from the other store. This is from Wunschelreel in Germany. I'm going to have to get mad at them because I can eventually use this, but it was supposed to be, maybe I did order the wrong one. It might be my fault, actually. That might be why there was two of them. I need to go look. Make sure, because I thought that I had ordered the curly that was under the curly one. Anywho, I'll use this anyway. It's not like I won't use it. I need to stop buying hair. It is a sickness. Okay, so let's see. The little male guy gave me my stuff through the window, so I didn't have to go out. But I did some, you can see I had some blushing on her. Let's see. Can you see? It's so dark in here. I don't know. There you go. You see the blushing on her. And I did her ears. So, I don't know. I think I don't want to make her too dark. And I think I like... She still needs to be a little lighter. Maybe I can bring that yellow up out of her skin if I did a flesh tone. Let's... Well, you guys can't even see anything. Over here. I was just saying, like, you see how... I don't know. Yeah, I think I better do another yellow. But I think maybe I'll do another yellow ochre because I'm afraid to do... This is so dark. Maybe if I need to mix it up. Maybe if I'll see if I can put any more water in it. If I can thin it out a little bit more. Because I usually do, the last wash, I usually do the raw sienna. This is the raw sienna. I think I'm just going to dump this and mix up some more because I know that I messed up and mixed in yellow ochre, but I'm going to make a fresh one of that. Actually, I think I'm just might get rid of that because it's all gross and use my new container. Okay, so I'll be back and we'll do that. Okay, bye. Okay, let's zoom in a little bit. Okay, so got my raw sienna. Is this one open? This is not the open one. See, I thought I was prepared. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, so I did all the powders on her. I did her little feeties and everything again. Her feet are done. I'm not going to put any more paint on her feet because I think they're done. Unless I do the, I might, if I do any, I will do the, there we go. I'll do the flesh wash, but this paint is a mess. Okay, so there we go. Put that in there. So we got this much paint. And I'm going to put that much satin glazing liquid. This is my wetting agent and water, distilled water. Again, tiny bit of wetting agent, lots of distilled water. So I just do a teeny tiny bit of wetting agent, like that much. And then the rest I put distilled water. Okay, I am going to make a wash, so I'm putting almost all the rest of that in there. Okay, that looks good. I'm going to have to mix up some more of this. Let's see, if I see the wetting agent up on top, I'll go ahead. I can't move my wheelchair right now, so I'll get it out and I'll show you guys how I mix that. Even though I've shown you before, I'm going to show you again. Show you again. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do, we'll just paint her head and I'll do a limb. And I'm going to go ahead and do the, what do you call it? I'm going to go ahead and paint on her ears because she's just not looking yellow enough yet for me. Let's hope this doesn't make her too dark. I'm going to go ahead and do the varnish I do want to show you guys how to varnish a baby with hair if they ever have to do that. And painting a baby with hair is about the same. So I'll go ahead and just show you what I do before I varnish and maybe part of the varnishing. Because I don't want to make this video too long. Okay. Because her vinyl is just so dark and she needs depth to her skin, but I don't want to make her too dark. Yellow is always seems easier to do washes with because it doesn't make streaks like the darker colors like blue and red and like the really, really dark colors, like the brown colors, the more brown colors, like the what's it called, burnt umber, things like that. I need another brush. Okay. I thought I had another brush, but there's some over there that I just don't want to reach across. Okay. So, I'll come back and show you what she looks like after she's dry, because when they're wet, they look darker and shinier. So, you got to wait until they dry to really see how they look. So, that will be back. Okay, I'm back. It's later in the day. So I got lunch and rest, took a shower, got my nice new fuzzy sweater on. It's cold finally. It's not cold. It's nice and sunny outside. If you guys can, see the outside. Here, hold on. I show you. See, nice and sunny outside. But it's still cool. So, okay, so I did. I'm gonna have to hold her over here so you guys can see. I did her the flesh wash, and then I did the she still looked a little like cold to me, like kind of bluish. So I did another like kind of light mottling. Well, it's a sponging really of the red. Those aren't her eyes. Those are just ones I popped in there so you guys can see what she looks like. But you see, she's kind of pinky pale, but because her vinyl's dark, it's hard to really get her pale unless I like seriously whitewashed her. But let me show you what she looks like in a different light. Okay, so what you want to do is, of course, make sure that the hair is all out. I did put I'm going to put a little bit of water over here. I did put a bunch of conditioner on his hair, but it's like all nice and soft already. So I'm putting water on this. And if you get like varnish in the hair, it'll come right out with, you can just go wash it. It'll come right off. So just brush the hair back so it's not like sticking in your varnish. You don't want the hair like stuck in your varnish. I still need to root some more hair right here, just right there. So I'm going to do that when I finish him up, when I finish up his varnish. I got too much to do. I need to get a move on. I don't want to skip over. And I'll just go ahead and paint Mealy in Ruben. Now I'm going to take a break of doing two babies at the same time, and well, after the Christmas babies, that is. And then we'll go back to just doing one at a time. At least rooting babies I'm gonna root. Okay, so we just go ahead and put a light coat of the varnish on here, and you just go up to the hairline as close as you can without getting varnish in the hair. But like I said, you get a little bit of varnish in the hair, it's not a big deal. You can go wash it out, because you're going to wash the hair anyway after you do this. Because you can either put like baby oil in the hair, or you can put like a lot of leave-in varnish in there. Or varnish. Leave-in conditioner in there. Either way, it'll help hold the hair back. So you're going to want to wash that out after you're done. So you just kind of, you're going to tap it in around the hairline. So that's basically all you do. After you get all the varnish on, you're going to just kind of lightly tap it in with a soft brush, soft dense brush. You want to go around the bumpy parts, like around the eyes, stuff like that, and the ears and the nose. So you don't leave any, like, pulled varnish. I got a hair. Like I said, I'm going to go wash his hair, so he won't have varnish hair. Alright, so it's easier to use a small brush around the hairline, too. There we go. Okay, so see, easy peasy. Okay, sorry, my hair's all wet. Okay, so this is what she looks like next to me. This makes a good screenshot. See, she looks like me. We have the same kind of skin tone, almost. So, she looks, I don't want her to be too dark, so. And I don't want her to look too cold either. I don't want her to be too, like, bluish looking. So, I'm going to stop there. We don't want to put any more paint on her. I think I like her lips like this. She looks good. I wouldn't change a thing. I may give her a little more blush here, but other than that, she looks really good. Okay, so now we're going to do the varnish, and yeah, when I come back, we'll be doing Mealy and Reuben. I am painting those dolls for my aide's daughter, so I'm going to do a cookie. I almost called her candy again. I'm going to do her head because I already have her limbs painted up there. And then I'm doing Rosebud for her younger daughter. So I'll be right back. Okay, so I am going to do a layer of soft touch on this because you can see it's really chalky and matte looking. So yeah, definitely needs some. So I'll show you what that looks like in the next video. My hair is so shaggy. I need a haircut really, really bad. Okay, so I'm going to go edit I'll probably edit it tomorrow because it's around now that my Wi-Fi goes bad. So, because everybody comes home from work and so on and so forth. Anyway, if you guys like what I'm doing, please like and subscribe and try to get me up to 1,000 subscribers and I'll do a giveaway toddler. Okay, so get some paint and a doll kit, an authentic doll kit, and paint a reborn because it's fun. Okay, bye.